Lesson 3. Defining parameters and units. So go ahead and open up PTV's VISSIM 7 and just let it load. There it is. And the first thing you're gonna do is go in File and Save As. In this case, since I'm doing this on my laptop, I just saved it onto my desktop. But if you are using the Fresno State Computer Labs, go ahead and save it onto your USB. And just create a folder first. Just name it whatever you like. I named it CE150 Project. Open that up. And then now we're naming our file name. I named it CE150. Barstow and Cedar, which is the intersection we'll be doing for this project. And go ahead and click Save and click OK. Now the first thing we're gonna do is define our parameters. So go to Simulation tab, hit Parameters, and you can type a comment if you like. And for a period, we're just going to leave it at 3600, which is the default. So enter the start time. In this case, use 12. Zero, 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 zero. And for the date, you can pick whatever you like. In this case, we just did the 1st.04.2017. And make sure to use periods there instead of the forward slashes. For our simulation reduction, just leave it at the default 10. Random seed, default, everything default. And scroll down to the number of cores, hit the drop down menu, and click on use all cores, and hit OK. And now we're ready to set the units. So go over to the signal control tab, actually base data tab, hit network settings, go to units tab. For the distance, miles, feet, inches, miles per hour, FPM, and feet per second squared, and hit all imperial. And hit OK. Alright, now that we set the units, we're going to import the desired speed distributions. Go to base data tab, scroll down to distributions, and hit desired speed. Let me just adjust this up a little bit so you can see. And these are just the defaults. So now we're going to right click and hit add. And this little graph is going to show up. So we're going to name this 40 miles per hour. Speed limit. And then right click to make a little red dot. And this doesn't have to be precise, but just make sure it looks similar to what I have here. There you go. And for the miles per hour, we're gonna change this to 60. And the one on the left is gonna go to 25. And you notice how the little red dots moved, but that's okay, we can just remove them again. Just click and drag. And again, this doesn't have to be precise, so just eyeball it. There you go, hit okay. And we're gonna do this several times. So one more time, hit right click, hit add. And we're gonna name this one 25 miles per hour speed limit. We're gonna try changing the miles per hour first this time to 50, and then the one on the left, change it to 15. Moving our little red dot. Adding another one. And let's put this one down here. Okay. Oh, that moved. So, but it's okay because you can always just right click on the one that you just did and hit edit. And you can move it back to where you wanted it to be and hit okay. You're going to do another one, right click, add. We'll name this one left turn MP, left turn movements. There we go. Miles per hour, 30 miles per hour. And change this one to 15. Adding our little red dots. There we go. And once again, they moved. So we're gonna edit that. There we go. Making a straight line. Hit okay. And again, hit add. This will be our right turn movements. Miles per hour, let's make it 30 as well, and 15. Make our little red dots. And they moved again, but it's okay, we can always just edit. That looks better. Okay. And that'll be all. Don't forget to save. And for next lesson 4, we'll be defining vehicle types and vehicle compositions.